slightly. Giving to families.
Well, good morning, students, teachers, and families who are watching online at home. Welcome to our dedication service for 2022. Now that you've just got comfortable, we would invite you please to respectfully stand as we sing our wonderful Australian National Anthem. Well, thank you everybody for singing our wonderful national anthem with such gusto. We are indeed the luckiest people in the world to live in this wonderful country of Australia. Thank you, Ms. Tolhurst, for leading us in that anthem. And thank you, Gintana, for accompanying us there on the keyboard as well. I would like to now do the acknowledgement of country. Today, we acknowledge our God and Saviour, Jesus Christ. We acknowledge you, Lord, because you are the creator, provider, and supreme owner of all things. We also respectfully acknowledge the Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander people who are the traditional custodians of the land. We pay tribute to elders past and present and acknowledge that they have cared for this country over countless generations. We recognise the continuing contribution that the Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander people make to the life of Australia and pray that we can work together to leave a legacy of reconciliation, justice and hope for all Australians. All of you just participated in one of the most powerful acts that a human being can do. That is, you were standing up and then you sat down. Did you know that sitting down can change the world? This lady on the screen, I'm sure many of you know her. Her name is Rosa Parks. an American citizen, in 1955, at the age of 42, she sat down on a bus in Montgomery, Alabama. You see, Montgomery, Alabama was a segregated community. It was a blight on the American social life, segregation. If you were of dark skin, you were segregated out from those who were white skin. It was a terrible situation. Black people could only drink from black drinking fountains. There were whites only over here. You could only go to a certain part of a restaurant, and often it was just a back window. On buses, white people sat at the front and black people had to sit at the back if there were seats available. If there were more white people, then blacks had to stand up and give their seat up to a white person. On this day, back in 1955, Rosa Parks, when she was asked to give up her seat for a white person, refused to do so. Therefore, setting in chain the American civil rights movement, the very act of sitting down has changed the face of America and also civil rights around the world. The bus driver, when she refused to move and stand and make way for a white man, said, "I will have to report this to the police because it was against the law." What a ridiculous law. This is her mugshot, though she was taken down to the local police station. She was fingerprinted by the local police officers. And there she is. Does anybody recognise the gentleman in the background? Martin Luther King Jr. Yes, there he was. He was present. You see, they were part of this movement that had been growing and growing. And it was Rosa Parks who set fire to the American civil rights movement. She is so famous in America that they even have a Barbie doll, the Rosa Parks Barbie doll. She's the only American woman, when she died, to have laid in state in the Capitol building. That's how important Rosa Parks is. Here's a couple of quotes. There are many quotes, and we could spend time, but we don't have the time. "You must never be fearful about what you are doing when it is right." Isn't that true? "Since I have always been a strong believer in God, I knew that He was with me, and only He could get me through the next step. I believe there is only one race, the human race. I would like to be remembered as a person who wanted to be free." One person can change the world. One person sitting down on a bus in 1955 changed the world. The act of sitting down is very, very powerful. And I want to ask you this morning, what powerful acts are you going to do when you're going to stand up for what is right? Remember Rosa Parks. She is a beacon of light for all of us, particularly we of faith who follow God, because we're challenged in this space all the time. Let's do what is right. It's my pleasure to welcome you to our dedication service this morning.
Good morning, everybody. My name is Austin Subban, and I'm the boys' primary school captain. It is our privilege to say prayer with you this morning.
Hello, everybody. My name is Brooke Woods, and I'm your girls' primary school captain. I would like to ask that you please close your eyes and bow your heads as we pray. Dear God, thank you for this wonderful morning where we can come together and devote ourselves to you. We are excited to see what you have planned this year.
We thank you for the opportunity to get a quality Christian education at a school where students and teachers aim to give their best. As we are starting a new year, we pray that you keep staff and students safe from harm. We thank you for bringing everyone here to join our Gilson College family. We are blessed to have a relationship with you, our Father in heaven, and to be part of your kingdom.
Today, we thank all the students, teachers, support staff members, and parents watching who look up to and worship you. We value the guidance you provide for us and the way you lead us to be the best version of ourselves.
Throughout this year, we constantly ask for your blessings to keep us healthy so we can come to school with energy to focus. We pray that all students get to have fun this year, learn a lot, and experience a heart transformation through you, Jesus. We pray a special prayer over all students completing the final year of schooling and that they do well in the VCE exams.
We have faced struggles in the past 2 years, but we pray that we can put those aside, start fresh, and focus on making this year one of our best. Please protect those in our community who are still struggling and give them the wisdom and strength to power through their hardships. Please continue to give our parents and guardians strength to help us through another year of learning as well.
As we come here today, we thank you for the sacrifice you made for us on the cross. We pray that you keep showering us with your love, protection, and guidance. Because of you, we get to be here at school and hopefully all year round.
We value the wonderful world you have created and are so grateful for all you have done for us. We love, appreciate, and will worship you always. In your glorious name, amen.
While we're getting set up, I just want to say good morning to my primary kids. Good morning, everybody. Yeah, that's how it's done. Excellent. Can I get everyone to stand? We're going to do some songs together. Standing quietly. Guys, these girls are going to lead you in the actions. We're going to sing There's no one like Jesus.
There's no one like Jesus. There's no
seat. Take a seat.
Actually felt like they were on that roller coaster. Oh my goodness, we all felt like we were on the roller coaster, sitting in the seat, ready, going up and coming back down, all to be up again. Where are my thrill seekers in the house? Put your hand up if you are a thrill seeker. Okay, we got some thrill seekers. Whether it's some of the fastest and craziest roller coaster rides, whether it's rock climbing, bungee jumping, abseiling, skydiving, you guys are up for the greatest adrenaline rushes that there is to have. All right, how many of you guys have seen some of these rides, have been on some of these rides, or recognized some of these rides? Ooh, okay, so what do we have there? We have the Superman Escape. We have the Green Lantern Coaster. Oh, I see so many people have been on these rides. We have the Batwing Space Shot, the Doomsday Destroyer, and other roller coaster rides like that. I know everyone's so excited right now. It's so excited. We've all been on the rides. Awesome, awesome, awesome. All right. Well, good to see that we have some brave souls in the house, people that have a need for speed, that actually enjoy the feeling that they get when they're on a roller coaster, that actually enjoy conquering your fears. So props to you guys. All right. Where are my people that like to play it safe? We like to play it safe. Okay, we got some safe players in the house. Thank you. Okay, I mean, like, look, we are up for a good time. You know, we can go on a ride or two. But we do actually value our lives. Yes? Amen? Yeah, we value our lives. All right, put your hand up if you are a little bit scared of roller coasters. Just a little bit scared of roller coasters. All right, all these people right here, you guys are my people, so I'm here to speak to you today. Nah, I'm playing. All right, so guys, funny story, right? I've actually only been on 3 roller coaster rides my whole entire life. 3 roller coaster rides! Can you believe it? That's crazy. I have been on the Scooby-Doo Spooky Coaster at Movie World. I have been on the Wild West Falls at Movie World. And I have been on the Great Scenic Railway that is in Luna Park in Melbourne. All right. Now, speaking about Luna Park, all right, my fear of roller coasters and of carnival rides of any sort is rooted and comes from a very vivid memory that I have when I was about 9 or 10 years old. My family and I were living in Victoria at the time. I was 9 or 10 years old and I went to Luna Park with my family, right? And I went on this ride with my dad and my sister. And the ride was called, I can't remember the name now. It's on the next slide. The ride was called the Twin Dragon. So this ride was a big dragon boat, all right? Maybe some of you guys have been on it. And I remember lining up for this ride with my dad and my sister. And they were keen, they were excited, they were like, yes. And my sister's 2 years younger than me, right? So I'm about 9 or 10, my sister's like seven, six, right? Anyway, so she is keen, she's excited, my dad's keen and excited, and we're about to get on this ride. But I don't know, I was feeling a bit nervous. Something just did not feel right about me going on this ride. But anyway, I hopped on it, and I'm sitting there in my seat, sitting between my dad and my sister. Okay, so the ride begins. It goes up and down, side to side. It starts so slow and then it gets faster and it gets higher and higher and higher. And I remember so vividly, I remember screaming and crying. I felt like my stomach was going to come out of my mouth. And my dad had to stand up on the ride, put his hands up, clap, scream, whatever he could do to get the attention of the guy that was manning the ride. And he had to tell the guy, you need to stop this ride. I need to get my daughter off this ride because she is so afraid. She is so scared. I was absolutely terrified. What are some of the feelings that we get and experience when we're just about to get on a roller coaster or when we're actually on the roller coaster? All right, all right. Does your heart begin to pound? Yes, hearts are pounding. Do you start to breathe really fast and heavy? Do your hands get sweaty? Do your knees begin to shake? And does your stomach feel like it's a pit filled of butterflies ready to escape? Those are the exact feelings I experienced before I got onto that ride. This adrenaline rush, this feeling like your stomach is turning, right? And if you're like me, fear and anxiety set in and you are afraid. And I want to ask you guys, what were your thoughts coming into this year? 2022, did you come in with that pre-roller coaster feeling? Your heart's pounding, you're breathing fast, it's heavy, your hands are sweaty, your knees are shaking, and your stomach feels like a pit full of butterflies ready to escape. Did you come into this year feeling like that? Not knowing what to expect, having been through the past 2 years. I know I did. I came into 2022 feeling exactly like that. There's a story in the Bible that is an awesome story in the Bible that's about a group of people, a nation, a city, and a king who came up against a situation that they did not see coming, a situation that they were not prepared for, a situation that probably and definitely had their hearts pounding, their breathing fast and heavy, their hands sweaty, their knees shaking, and their stomachs feeling like a pit full of butterflies ready to escape. This story is about a king named Jehoshaphat. All right, but for today, we're going to call him King Joe. Can everybody say King Joe?
King Joe!
We're talking about King Joe today. All right, King Joe, he was a really good king, right? He was a really, really good king. He was loved and respected by his people, and he respected and loved his people. But most of all, King Joe respected and loved God, right? So we're talking about King Joe and the nation of Judah, the people of Judah. So one day, while King Joe is doing his king things that a king does, King Joe gets a message, a really distressing, urgent message from one of the people in his city. And this guy comes up to King Joe and he says, King Joe! There's three armies coming up against us, and they're coming now. Three armies coming up against us, and they're coming now. They're about to attack you and us. The Bible says, right, I'm reading this from 2 Chronicles chapter 20. The Bible says, the armies of the Moabites, Ammonites, and some of the Meunites declared war on King Joe, declared war on Jehoshaphat. Right? They joined forces. This army made up of three nations were coming from the other side of the Dead Sea. They were sneaking up behind, making their way around and up ahead to attack. There was no time. Jehoshaphat literally had no time to waste. He had to think very carefully about what he was going to do. And King Joe did the one and only thing that he could do, and that was to go to God. Now, he was terrified. All right, let's get this right. King Joe, he's a whole king. Could you imagine? Do you guys think kings are supposed to be afraid? Kings that lead massive nations and cities and people, do you think they're supposed to be afraid? Nah, man. Yeah, sometimes, maybe it depends. No, they're not supposed to be afraid. They got to put on a brave face because everybody is watching them. But you know what? King Joe does something really incredible. The first person the first person. Now, I love this, right? Because in the chapter before, King Joe chooses leaders in his nation. He chooses leaders. And usually, right, a king, he would think, okay, I'm going to go to my leaders first, find out from them what we should do. But no, he goes straight to the big man upstairs. He goes straight to God. King Joe begs God, God, I don't know what to do. I need your help. We need your help. So King Joe, he seeks God, right, first. First he seeks God, and he makes God his go-to person. Now I'm sure you guys have some go-to people in your lives, your teachers, your friends, your parents, your cousins, aunties, uncles, right? These people that you look up to, that person for King Joe was God. All right, we then see the people of Judah come together, right? They come together kind of like what we're doing here today, united under one roof, in one place, for one purpose, right? That's what Dedication Chapel is about today. So these people come together and they are ready to hear what their king has to say. And they're quietly waiting, just as quiet as you all are right now, ready to hear this word from their king. And their king gets up and their king tells them this. First of all, he's afraid, right? He's terrified. He could have gotten up there and he could have transferred all that fear into these people and said, man, we got three armies coming up against us. There's only one of us. We ain't got the weapons they have. We ain't got the resources they have. We ain't got nothing that they have. 3:1. King Joe gets up in front of his people. He confesses, I'm afraid, right? I know I'm your king, but I'm afraid. He then tells them, but we have a God that we can trust. We have a God that's going to come through for us. He claims the power of God. He reminds his people, yo, remember that same God that took you out of Egypt? That same God that led you through the desert? The same God that provided water for you and food for you, shade and warmth? That's the same God. He's done it before. He's going to do it again. King Joe tells his people that. He prays with and for his people. I'm here to tell you guys today, the battle is not yours, right? Further on in the story, these guys have to fight. They actually have to go out and fight this army. They had a job to do, okay? They actually had three things that they had to do. First, oh yeah, look at this. This is what the Lord says, right? So something crazy happened, something random and crazy happened. Someone from the audience and the people of Judah stood up and they said this, Lord, this is what the Lord says. Do not be afraid. Don't be discouraged by this mighty army, for the battle is not yours but God's. The battle is not yours but God's. This year is not yours but God's. This year is not ours but God's. God is bigger than our battles, and God wants his battle back. Right, these people did have three things to do though. They had to show up. In the previous verse, God actually tells them, yo, I know the battle's mine. I know yours are scared, but you don't even have to fight, right? They didn't even have to fight, but they did. They did have to show up. Yes, the battle wasn't theirs. Yes, they didn't have to fight, but that didn't mean that they got to kick back, chill out, relax, take a back seat, and do nothing. No, they had to stand up. Not even stand up, they had to stand still. God told him, stand still in front of that army when you face them. Stand still in front of that army. Show up to the battle. Take your positions. You don't have to fight it, but you do have to face it. We don't got to fight the battles this year, but we do have to face this year and everything that comes with it. The good, the bad, the ugly, the beautiful, you name it. The second thing they had to do was let go. King Judah and the people had to let go of control. They had to do the one thing that humans hate to do the most. We like to have control. We want to do things our way, and we want the results to be the very best, and we want credit for the success, right? But they had to let go of that. King Joe, being a king, he had to be like, no, I've got to lay down my crown and lift up God's. The last thing that these people had to do was let God. By standing still and watching God do what only God can do best. Now, if you guys thought that was crazy, right? They had to show up, let go, and let God. The next morning, they showed up to the battle, right? They showed up to the battle. The king, you know what King Joe did? So we already know that they don't have weapons that the other armies have. They don't have the resources that other armies had. But you know what they did have? They had a choir. Can you believe it? They had a choir. Where in World War I or II did soldiers and armies send their choir out in front of the battlefield? Man, if that ain't faith, I don't know what is. If I was King Jay, I don't even know if I could have the faith to do that. But that he sends his choir out in front before everybody else. And these guys are singing, man. See that worship band you guys just heard just then? This chapel band, God sent that chapel band out there. And they were doing their thing. And God showed up while they were singing praises. This year, we have three things to do. I want to ask you guys, how are you going to show up? How are you going to show up in your lives? How are you going to show up at school? Achieve the best grades that you can achieve. Right? You guys have all so much potential. I just look out and I see a sea of potential. Don't waste this time. Okay? Don't waste this time. How are you going to show up in the lives of your families, in your households? For your mom, for your dad, for your siblings, how are you going to show up for them? How are you going to lend a hand? How are you going to show up for your friends? Think about that. Second thing, we got to let go. What are you guys going to let go of this year? What baggage are you carrying from last year, the past years, or years way far back there? What are you going to let go of this year? And the last question I'm going to ask you is, how can we let God this year? How can we let God show up and do what only God can do best? This year in 2022, this dedication chapel, we are claiming the power of the God that we serve. We are claiming that he is bigger than any battle that we're about to face. We're going to sing through 2022 if we have to. And you know what? We're actually going to win. We're going to win this year, because this year we are living forward and we're looking up.
Thank you very much, Pastor Chanel, for that very powerful encouragement for all of us. And what a great story for us to start the school year with. It's come time now for our dedication pledges. At Gilson College, there are three very important groups: our staff, our students, and our families and friends. And this morning, we have a representative from each one of those groups who are going to read out their pledge. And so, students and staff, for our first dedication pledge, it's going to be our staff. And I would like you all now to give a huge Gilson applause for Mr. Galtz, who's going to give the staff pledge this morning.
I'd like all of our staff here at Gilson College for 22 to please stand up. Just our staff. Students, you can stay seated. So just our staff. We, the staff of Gilson College, humbly acknowledge God as the source of all of our wisdom, knowledge, and grace. We dedicate ourselves and our school to his service. By standing this morning, we accept the huge responsibility that we share with parents in educating our students and leading them to our Saviour. We thank God for the wonderful students that he's brought into our care, and we commit ourselves to knowing, encouraging, and teaching each one, enabling them to be the people that God designed them to be. We place ourselves in God's hands for this year, knowing that he can do awesome things through us. Thank you, staff. Please be seated.
Thank you very much, Mr. Galtz. Now, representing our students this morning, we are pleased to announce our school captains for the secondary, Tayani Ratanaki and Daniel Macheski, who are going to read out the student pledge. Can we give them a big Gilson applause and welcome everybody?
Good morning, staff, students, and parents. Today we have been given the privilege to read out the student pledge. Could we get all the students to stand up, please? We, the students, thank God for our school. We are grateful for the opportunity to learn new skills and discover new ideas. As we face each new challenge, we know that through God's strength, we will succeed.
We thank our families for their love and support and for enabling us to come to this school. We thank our teachers for the role they play in helping us to reach our potential. We place ourselves in God's hand for this year, knowing that He can do awesome things through us. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, students. You may be seated. I'd like to welcome to the podium our family and friends representative this morning. Mrs. Joanne Zaragoza. Can we give her a big Gilson welcome, everybody? Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Farquharson. Good morning, students, teachers, and parents who are watching from home. We, the family and friends, thank God for our children and for the privilege of nurturing them in Him. We love our children and want the very best for them. We place our children in the care of the teachers, knowing they are committed to sharing our responsibility. We offer our teachers a support, encouragement, and prayers, knowing that God will be our strength. We place ourselves in God's hands for this year, knowing that He can do awesome things for us through Him. Thank you.
Now's your chance to sing again, so can I get you to stand again, please?
What song are we singing? Great. I can pick up my voice from all the way down there.
I dare not try. Hello, everyone. Good morning. Let's bow our heads for our last prayer for the day. Our gracious Heavenly Father, we come before you in prayer to acknowledge you as the creator of the universe, gracious and compassionate, slow to anger, and abounding in steadfast love. We acknowledge you as the leader and the go-to of our school. We thank you for the gift of forgiveness and eternal life offered through your Son Jesus on the cross. Lord, we draw near to you because we know that you will answer those who come to you and you will show them great and unsearchable things. Today, we dedicate Gilson College and this new year, 2022, to you. Lift up our teachers to you, that their words will be wise and their hearts filled with wisdom. Lift up our support staff to you, that they will be people of kindness and compassion as they follow your example. Lift up your students to you, that they may grow in wisdom and stature. And we lift up our families to you, that each come home representing what we have here at school, and that they can grow in faith. We know that if we do not love, Lord, we don't know you, because you are love. So this year, Lord, may we be a school that is known to be a school of love. And may we know you, the only true God, and Jesus Christ, whom you have sent. Lord, may our community know and recognize who we are, a Christian college who follows you because of the way we love another. It is our prayer, Lord, that this year we will love you with all our heart, all our soul, and all our minds, and we may learn to love others as much as we love ourselves. May the grace of Jesus, your lover, Lord, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all. To you, Lord, we dedicate our school and all the power and glory to you forever and ever. Amen.
Thank you, Pastor Pauline. And we would just like to say a huge thank you to the group who have put together our wonderful dedication chapel this morning. There's been a lot of work go into preparing, and it's just been great for all of us to be together in this place at this time. We'd like to thank our families and friends who have joined us online and the live stream. That stream is going to finish right now. Thank you for joining us. It's been great having you here. I'd like to say to students and staff, top marks for the very respectful way that you have entered the auditorium today, and we would like to leave it in the same way. So I'd like you please just to listen very carefully for your instructions. Year 12, if you could please remain behind, I believe that you're going